y'all, and welcome back to the garden. I hope you are ready to start making some gifts, whether it's for Christmas or for a birthday or what have you. This is what we're going to be making. Some Christmas presents that you can wood burn. All you need is a wood burning kit and some wood. So let's take a look. Okay, to make this present, you want to start off with a piece of wood. It's a piece of poplar, and you can see it's got nice wood grain, and it's pretty soft. You can put an indention in the wood. Now this one I bought, it was 4 feet long and 6 inches wide. You can see right here that I measured the length that I wanted and I drew a line on it. So most of these I'm trying to make them 8 to 9 inches long. Now I did have my husband cut the boards for me and I sure did appreciate it. And what I did, I took my notepad and I just wrote something on one of the pieces of paper. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this and I'm going to put it on my piece of wood. And I've been having to use a fork. I know that sounds crazy, but I've been having to use a fork to actually indent the words onto the wood. Now right here you can see where I've taped the piece of paper to my wood. And I'm just going to go over the words I've already written with my fork, and this puts an indention in the wood that I can see so that I can actually, you know, lightly pencil it in once I get finished with it. Okay, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see this. Okay, so maybe you can't really see it, but in real life, you'll be able to see the words. And then I'm just taking my pencil, lightly write the words on the board where I made the indention, like so. And you can see that it says, "Peace on Earth." After I do that, I heat up my little wood burner and I burn the words into the wood. Okay, before I start on my board, I've just got a blanket over my legs. I got a cookie sheet with a piece of towel on it. And that's what I'm going to woodwork on. That's what, because I'm dealing with a really hot burning tool. Next comes the fun part. You want to be careful when you're doing your wood burning. You get your tool really, really hot. And you just start burning the wood. You might want to do a practice board one time just so you can find out how to use your tool. I usually do my straight lines first. And it's a good thing to do it outside because this stuff, when it burns, it lets off some smoke and you don't want to be breathing that all the time. Plus, it's kind of cold outside here today, so it keeps my fingers from getting too hot. Okay, the next thing you want to do after you get your words burnt in there, look at the wood grain, and you can just kind of go along and enhance some of the wood grain. Just make it show up just a little bit. It'll show up really good after we stain it too. All right, once you got a few of your little details on there, you can come in here. Now what I like to do is I like to burn this edge right here. Maybe burn the corners a little bit. And then you can go in here on the sides and you see where I made one little line here. Set your wood burner in and let it burn on down into the wood a little bit. And the reason you're going to do this is you kind of want your wood to look old. And this will be nice. Okay. So you can see here how I've burnt the wood with the edges to make it actually look like the edge of the wood. And see how I burnt the top, I burnt the sides and the bottom, and then I burnt those edges into the wood to make it look like a board. Okay, the next thing you want to do is erase any pencil lines that you might have left. Okay. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is stain my wood. And for this, I'm going to use the wood finish. It's a Minwax, and this one stains, penetrates, and seals. Now, if you're going to hang them outside, after you stain them, you can come back over them with a polyurethane that'll protect them. Now, this one is for indoor-outdoor. So, if you hang them outside, make sure you protect them with an indoor-outdoor type of polyurethane. And I'm just going to stain this. I'm going to stain all the ends and the sides and the back of it too. Okay. I've got it all stained up. Oops. And that's what it's going to look like when you get finished staining it. Okay, the next thing you want to do is you want to measure on the top, maybe an inch over on each side, so that you can put a little hanger. I'm using eye screws. These are the screw eyes that I bought, and they're only half inch. And then I'm going to take just a little bitty nail, and I'm just going to tap it in there, so that I can have a little hole to get my eye screw in there. Now once I put my eye screw down in there and I screw it in a little bit, probably need to take a little nail and stick it in the eye screw and just turn it. Just turn it around and around till the eye screw goes down in there. And we'll try to turn them all like so. And then you'll be ready to put your wire or your jute string or whatever kind of hanger you want to use. And I'll show you that. There you have it. And for this project, I'm going to use just a jute rope. Okay, I'm just going to pull some of the string out. I'm going to put it through here. Just put it through the little eye screw, and I'm going to make a knot. Just going to loop it through there. I'm going to determine how much I want it to hang. And I'm going to put a knot in it again, like that. Cut it off, and there you have it. You got your little hanger, got your eye screws, you've got it stained, you got it burned, and I think that's a really cute little present you can make for somebody. Here's my little baskets that I bought to put my gifts in. And here's one of the signs. Everything this year is homemade. Here's some pepper sauce that I made. And a card. And I'm sending everybody some hot chocolate. And a sign. And that's what I'm doing for Christmas this year. And then I'm going to wrap it up, put a nice bow at the top, and give it away for Christmas. Hey, y'all. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you have a Merry Christmas, and we'll see you next time here back at the garden.